Kyle Bradshaw from Chaparral Motorsports here with Jason from Liqui Moly. Today, we're going to be talking about Motorcycle Oil 101. Now, Jason, there's lots of different motorcycle oils on the market. There's people that are on the forums that like to say that, Castrol Red Cap is the best, and they use it for cars, it's cheap, and they can use it in their motorcycles too. What really is the difference between an automotive oil and a motorcycle oil?
So automotive oils, you know, there's different, obviously, RPM ranges in your car, right? Your car may be at like 3,000 to 5,000 RPM range. So in a motorcycle, you could be, let's just say, 8,000 plus RPM range. And yeah, even though it may have the same oil pressure flow through the system, there's a different shear factor taking place inside the engine. So whenever everybody comes up to us and says, oh man, I use the automotive grade oil in my bike, I've used it for years. It's like, yeah, it will get you by. But that doesn't mean it's going to be the best thing to protect the engine.
So if you were stranded in the desert, punched a hole in your case, and the only thing around was this F-250 driving by with some oil in the back of his truck, it's better than nothing.
It'll get you by.
But it'll get you back home again. But make sure you get that swapped out for traditional motorcycle oil. Now, as far as Liqui Moly goes, you guys service lots of different brands and styles of motorcycles. You have Harley Davidson specific oil.
We do.
You've got dirt bike basically specific oil. How do you guys break those down? How do the specific oils get created?
So the neat thing for us is being a manufacturer, everything's made in our facility in Germany. Mm-hmm. You know, everything is, all the additive packs that we make them in-house. Whereas a lot of
other... So real quick, what is an additive pack?
An additive pack is basically like a chemical ingredient that will go in for a specific result, like whether it's a temperature range or whether it's the evaporation rate of the product. Mm-hmm. There's differences in all kinds of engines, from a turbocharged engine, from a non-turbo engine, and the different scenarios that they're put in. So when we're targeting something specific, let's say like the HD stuff, those things are super hot. They have to have a certain additive pack to keep them cool and protected. Side-by-side market is another one. I've noticed the side-by-side market, especially with the turbocharged cars, if they don't actually have the proper product in there and the evaporation rate of the product basically goes into the engine, builds a bunch of carbon buildup inside of there, it's something that's not helping the engine. So we try to tailor it towards whatever we're building the product for.
Now, obviously, inside the owner's manual to your motorcycle, you're going to see a breakdown of what oil your motorcycle recommends. You're going to have a weight, so you're going to have an SAE 10 and then W40 or 1050 or 530. The numbers can vary dramatically. Now, my 950 KTM takes a lot different oil than my BMW. So you really need to take a look at your owner's manual, find out what specific weight of oil that your bike takes. But that's not the only number. Can you explain a little bit about the API, the SL, the JASO, the MA2? Why do people need to look at those numbers and letters?
The biggest thing is when you're going to the shelf and you're looking at the API rating, mm-hmm. the most current one is obviously the latest product that's been developed. You know, there's still older specs that will meet and exceed. It'll work fine. Okay. I think the biggest confusion in the market that people don't know is mainly the wet clutch approval. So as long as you're looking on a bottle and you've got a wet clutch, which is probably 80-90% of the power sports market have a wet clutch, you want to make sure it says at least JASO MA or JASO MA2. Mm-hmm. MA was the first wet clutch approval. JASO MA2 is the most current one. Both will work fine.
So what happens if you use an oil that's not approved for a wet clutch?
You'll definitely get slippage in the clutch.
And why is that?
The additive pack that's in there is basically too slippery and will cause those things to slip.
Perfect.
Yep.
So now this is a fully synthetic motor oil. Now, what would be the difference between a fully synthetic, a semi-synthetic, and then a traditional oil?
So you've got your basic, you've got a full synthetic group 3, and then you got group 4 oils. Basic oils are going to be for, like, let's say 1990s and below.
Okay.
Those type of engines, the materials that they're made out of, the seals that are inside those engines, those oils are perfectly compatible with those engines.
Cool.
As soon as you basically kind of go from there up, you generally want to go into a full synthetic. It's going to have better temperature range to protect the bike. The additives are going to be better, again, for the shear factor in those engines. The RPM ranges are completely different as well.
Interesting.
So we do a basic, we do a full synthetic group 3, which is this. This is mainly a consumer full synthetic, and then we do full-blown race oils as well.
So what would make a race oil different than, say, this full synthetic?
The temperature range and the abuse it can be. That's
so it can just be wrung out at super high RPMs for a longer duration of time?
Exactly.
Obviously, race bikes were changing the oil after every race anyway, so the amount of time the oil actually sits in the bike is relatively small. Mm-hmm. So do you do, like, more protection for that high RPM but less detergent because it gets changed more often for the standard consumer?
Exactly.
Interesting.
Yep.
So it's just a matter of, so basically the amount of oil that your chamber holds, how much of that do we want to have as the actual oil?
Yes.
How much do we want to have as the additive? How much do we want to have as, that's interesting, very interesting.
Exactly, because you can only squeeze so much right in this container,
yeah,
right? You've got to have so much additive pack of protection and that's how they'll all vary because ultimately a race oil is something that you're going to change on a regular basis. It's not something that you put in an engine and forget about.
Cool.
Yeah.
So that's just general oil tips, so oil 101. Now, as far as Look at Molly goes, you guys are a specialist in the industry as far as motorcycle power sports oils go. What makes Look at Molly different?
I think the biggest difference for us is being an actual manufacturer. A lot of people, you know, we've come to the U.S. market about 2 years ago, okay. And a lot of people don't know that we're a true manufacturer that actually started as an additive company back in the 1950s.
Interesting.
So it kind of evolved into a full oil manufacturer, but started as an additive company.
So what I'm hearing from you is Liquid Moly used to have, you know, containers about this size that you would then add to whatever oil you're choosing off the shelf. So if you're choosing a Motorex oil, a Honda oil, a Yamalube, whatever you were using,
yep,
you could then take a Liquid Moly additive pack, add that in to get the specific characteristics you're looking for.
Exactly.
But now you guys said, okay, we've been doing that for a long time.
Yep.
We are in the oil space. Now we're just gonna bring our own oil to the market with those things already included.
Exactly. So the product offering is the range is huge. We do over 4,000 products.
Wow.
We only have about 350 in the US between automotive and power sports. But that all basically is the additives and the oils that we've brought over so far. There's some things that we actually can't even bring into the US, mainly our aerosols.
Okay.
But that's because of the VOC content that we have here, the regulations, so.
Gotcha, there you go. So Liquid Moly makes a phenomenal oil that's motorcycle specific for you, any of your power sport vehicles. They've also got other additives. This one here is a speed additive. It's called the Speed Shooter. It's kind of fun. You throw that into your gas tank, and what's that gonna do for you?
So what that does, this one shooter will treat 1 to 2 gallons. What it's going to do when you get it in the gas tank, it takes a few minutes to kind of mix in, but it's going to atomize the fuel and speed up the combustion process of the fuel, which results in better throttle response down low. A lot of guys will ask us, oh, is it the same thing as an octane boost? And that's not, it's completely different. It's safe. You want to make sure you properly dose it. Even if you go a little over, you're not going to harm the bike. It's only going to atomize the fuel so much.
Beautiful.
So.
Cool, and then here's another option or another package that we're gonna be using today. This is actually called Engine Flush Shooter. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna put this into your existing oil. You're gonna run it for how long?
10 minutes.
10 minutes.
Yep.
That's gonna basically break down the deposits that have accumulated inside your motor. And then when you drain that oil out, those contaminants are all gonna leave the motor. It's a great thing to do every 3 or 4 oil changes to make sure you keep your motor fresh.
Exactly. Yep. The one thing I want to specify, it is power sports specific.
Okay.
We get asked all the time. Guys will see, you know, they'll walk into a different automotive store and see the similar product, Liquid Moly Engine Flush. There is completely differences between all of our additives. This is power sports specific, which is a very important thing to know because the clutch plates, again, we talked about the wet clutch earlier. You don't want to just put an oil engine flush in your bike because it will delaminate the clutch plates. Right. So that's exactly why we came out with this product. It's safe. You're not going to harm your clutch plates. You're not going to harm any of the materials in the engine.
And there you go. Motorcycle Oils 101 with Jason from Look at Molly. I'm Kyle Bradshaw from Chaparral Motorsports. Thanks for joining us today. Please like and subscribe to this video if you like the content and want to see more of it in your inbox. Thanks for watching. Until next time, take care and ride safe.